guys, this is Adi from Best of Beauty and welcome back to my channel. So I really hope that all of you guys are doing well and are staying safe as well in your houses. So I thought that I should just sit down and film like a long video for you guys trying on new beauty products because I just bought a lot of stuff from Nykaa and I have like a bunch of new makeup to try out. So let's just sit down and you know, put makeup on and yeah, let's get started. Before we begin, I would just like to say that if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, then make sure you hit on the red subscribe button. It really mean a lot and yeah, let's get started. So first I'm going to moisturize my face and for that I'm going to be using this Embryo Lace Concentrate and it's a really good thick moisturizer and I love using this before applying any sort of base product. So I'm just going to apply that. Y'all should definitely check this out if you're applying makeup on a day-to-day basis and y'all want like a really moisturizing, you know, base. Now that my skin is moisturized, let's move on to foundation. And today I'm going to be using this one, which is a new product obviously. And this is the Nude Sticks Tinted Cover Foundation. And I got this on Sephora's website. I'm really excited to try this out because I've heard such good reviews about it. And this is what the packaging looks like. It comes in this tin. And you know, these tins can be used for a lot of other reasons as well. So I'm just going to take this product out right now. So this is how the product looks like. As you all can see that it has a really simple packaging and you can see the shade that you've got. It also has a pump dispenser, which is great because you obviously don't want the product all over the place. And I've got the shade 04 in this and I really hope that it works out because they don't have a lot of shades and I obviously bought this online. So what this foundation does is that it's supposed to give you, you know, a little bit of coverage. And it also evens out your skin tone and it moisturizes your face and also protects it. So that's really great because obviously I would want to use a base product that's going to, you know, hydrate my skin and obviously treat it as well. And yeah, let's just use this on our face and see how it looks like. So I am just going to like take that much. And I'm going to be using my fingers to apply this product because obviously the consistency of this is like really sheer and liquidy and I think that fingers will do a better job of blending. So just applying like a couple of, you know, drops on my face. The shade that I picked out for myself really works, as you can see, and I'm really happy about that because obviously it's a really expensive product and I cannot return it, so that's a great sign. And now I am just going to blend this. It definitely feels really moisturizing on the skin. And it has provided like a glow to my face as well. I don't know if you can see that. But as I mentioned that this is a really sheer coverage foundation. So if you are looking for like full coverage and you know you want to cover everything on your face, then this is definitely not the foundation for you. Because as you can see, I have these dark spots over here and it hasn't covered that. So I'm obviously going to use a concealer on top. But right now it feels really lightweight on my skin and it almost feels like I'm not wearing any base product, which is great because that's what I love. I want my skin to breathe through, you know, whatever I'm putting on my face. Especially in this humid weather of Mumbai, you don't want to put something heavy. So this is how the foundation looks like once it's blended into the skin and it feels really lightweight and has provided like sheer coverage also and feels really nourishing and moisturizing. But obviously this is a very expensive product and you know, if you are someone who is looking for an expensive CC cream, I would say, then you can go for something like this. But obviously it's not budget friendly, so it's all up to you. I'm obviously going to try this more to see if I like it or not. Next, let's move on to concealers, and that has to be one of my favorite products to use on my face because on a day-to-day basis I just prefer using concealer under my eyes and that's about it. I don't like using foundation. So I've actually got 4 new concealers because I love trying them out. The first up we have this one, which is the Milani Conceal and Perfect Concealer, and I absolutely love this. This has to be by far the best concealer that I've ever tried. The consistency of this is just right, and it just beautifully covers everything, and it still looks so lightweight, and obviously it's really long lasting as well, and there are many shades to choose from. So I already used the shade 145. So I thought that I should try a shade lighter as well. So I got shade 140. And this is what that one looks like. I'm obviously going to leave all of the product links in the description box below, so you can check it out for yourself. Now let's move on to the other one that I got, which is this one, which is the Flower Beauty Light Illusion Concealer. And I have heard really great reviews about this one as well. And I've got the shade Light Medium. Next is a high-end concealer, and it's from Estee Lauder, and this is the Double Wear Instant Fix Concealer, and I love Estee Lauder's concealers. They have some great base products as well, and I've tried the Double Wear Concealer, which I absolutely love. If you're looking for a high-end concealer, you should totally check that one out. So I thought that I should give this one a go as well. So as you can see that this is a dual-sided product. On one side you can, you know, nourish your under eyes with this serum, and then you have the concealer on this end. Lastly, we have this one, which is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer, and I've got the shade 130 Medium. Now, I've obviously tried Maybelline concealers before. I've tried Fit Me as well, but for some reason, I just don't find the right shade for my skin tone, which is really absurd. And that's the reason I end up not liking any of their concealers. And I've tried Instant Age Rewind before as well, and that also shade did not work for me. And I think that this one also is not going to work, because it looks really light in the packaging. So I think that I should just not buy Maybelline concealers anymore, or maybe buy them in the store, because clearly on the website I cannot choose the right shade for myself. So today I'm actually going to use the Flower Beauty concealer, and let's see if it works. What they have said is that this is supposed to be really weightless, and it's crease proof as well, and it instantly diminishes the appearance of fine lines, fatigue, and it gives a flawless luminous look. So let's see if it actually performs. I like the packaging on this, it's really cute. So just gonna apply this right under my eyes. This definitely feels a bit lighter, because I like to use concealers that are, you know, similar to my skin tone. And to blend all of this in, I'm gonna be using my favorite pack 272 brush. Just going to blend it under my eyes. Just look at that. It looks really good, isn't it? And it still feels really lightweight. Does not feel heavy whatsoever. I definitely do feel that this provides like light to medium coverage. And if you have like dark circles which are really prominent, then I don't think that this is going to cover it that well, because it's really lightweight. So our base is done, and I'm really loving it so far, because it feels really natural and lightweight. Now let's move on to eyes, and I've just got this Huda Beauty Obsessions palette in the shade Amethyst, and just look at these beautiful shades. It has just such nice purple and mauve tone shades in it, and obviously it's really pigmented as well. The reason I got this is because, you know, I have like a lot of neutral toned palettes in my collection, and I don't have anything this colorful. So I was really getting bored of using the same shades, and I thought that I would experiment. And trust me, I'm loving using colorful eyeshadows in like different ways, and I probably might purchase more of these as well. And I've done like a lot of tutorials on my Instagram wherein I've used all of these colorful shades, so you should definitely check it out. So today I think that we should really keep it simple, because obviously our base is so simple, and if I do like a heavy eye look, then it's not going to complement that well. So I feel like I'm going to be using this nice pinky shade right here, and I'm using the Morphe 441 brush. And I love that even though this palette is so tiny, it has a mirror, so it's just very convenient. And I'm just going to apply this shade in my crease. And I've recently done two new videos on eyeshadow application for beginners, so you should definitely check those out too. I'm going to leave a link over here, or maybe in the description box, because they're really informative. So I'm actually just going to leave it at that and not do too much. And next, I'm going to be lining my eyes with this Colourbar All Matte Eyeliner. And this is also a recent purchase. And this is in the shade Dark Brown. And this is what that one looks like. And I really like using brown eyeliners because I feel like black can look too intense sometimes. And obviously, as you can see, that my eyes are really small, so I don't want to, you know, apply something that is going to make it look even more smaller. And I love its applicator, actually, as you can see that it's really precise. And just swatching it right here, wow. As you can see that this just glided on so smoothly on my eyes and I didn't have to go over it again. So this is how it looks like. Now this eyeliner is definitely not waterproof, but it says that it's supposed to last for 16 hours and let's see if it does actually. I don't know if it's going to, but I love the way it looks and the consistency is really great. Now for lashes, I have a new mascara and this is the Flower Beauty Lash Warrior and I've heard again great reviews about this. So let's see how it looks. Now this is what the applicator looks like. As you can see, as you can see it has like a slight curve to it. So I think that it's going to be really great to, you know, just lengthen your lashes and wiggle it very well. I love the fact that when I took out the wand, it doesn't have too much product on it and that suggests that it's not going to make my lashes look clumpy. Whoa. Just like one coat of this mascara and it has added so much length to it. And it's like really black as well. I mean, I don't know if you can see, I think showing mascara on camera is like the most difficult thing, but it has definitely added a lot of length. So the good thing about this mascara is that even though I've applied like 2-3 layers of this, it still feels like I've not applied a lot of product on my eyes and it's not weighing my eyelashes down because some mascaras can do that. So far, really impressed with this. It definitely added a lot of length and volume as well. Now moving on to blush, I thought that I should, you know, try out a new blush as well because I feel like blush is that one product that you maybe like buy like one or two and you have like staples and you don't actually, you know, go out for, you know, hunting for new blushes. So I thought that I should do it this time and I tried this one, which is the Sugar Mini Blush in the shade Peach Peak. So this is what the packaging looks like and this is the shade right here. As you can see that this is like a really nice peachy pink shade, but it's not too intense and it's not going to be over the top. So I think that this sort of a shade is perfect for like a day-to-day use. But I just don't like the packaging of this. I feel like the quality could have been better, but can't complain because it only is for like 500 rupees. Using my favorite Morphe E4 brush, I'm just going to take the product on it. Why does it feel like it's not picking up anything? Hopefully it does. Ooh, it's a beautiful shade for sure. So I feel like the pigment on this is not as strong and you have to like go into the product like multiple times to actually see any color payoff. Which can be a good thing because you obviously don't want a really intense blush. But I feel like it's not showing up so well and I have to like keep going again and again. And it's not the most beautiful formula of blush that I've ever tried. It feels a bit powdery as well. This is how it looks like and as you can see that the color is definitely pretty, no doubt about that. But I'm not a big fan of the formula. I feel like it could have been a little bit more creamy and a little bit more, you know, pigmented as well. And this shade in particular is going to suit light to medium skin tones. It's definitely not going to suit duskier skin tones because it's really light. Now let's move on to lips and I obviously had to get a lip product every time I shop. And this one is the Sugar Lip Liner and this is in the shade Wooed by Nude and this is what that one looks like. So it's a pencil lip liner, and I love pencil lip liners. They're much better and more precise as compared to the twist up ones. And it also comes with its own sharpener, which is great. And this shade was obviously calling out to me because it's like a rosy nude shade, and I love that kind of shade. So I'm just going to swatch this for you. Just look at that. How pretty is this? It's like my perfect shade. Like, I honestly have all of my lipsticks in this particular shade. It's just like a really nice coral and, you know, rosy shade. This just glided on so effortlessly, because sometimes, you know, lip liners can be really drying, but this does not feel drying whatsoever. And I feel like this sort of a lip liner, you can use it like all over your lips as well, because it's so moisturizing. I'm really liking this lip liner, and I'm definitely gonna get more shades in this. As you can see, it's a beautiful shade, and I feel like it's such a universal shade that it's gonna suit like all skin tones. And lastly, we have this, which is the MAC setting spray, and I'm just gonna spritz this all over my face. So I had this like a couple of years ago, but it like fell down, and obviously the product was all over the place. So since then, I actually never purchased it again. So I'm just gonna spritz my face with this. So this is how my base looks like, and I'm really impressed that so many of these products turned out so well, and I did not have to regret purchasing them. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you still want, you know, me to give like an in-depth review on any of these products, then definitely let me know in the comments down below, because I would love to do that. And if you like this video, then make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and share it with your friends. And also don't forget to subscribe to my channel. It will really mean a lot. And yeah, I will see you guys in the next one. Love you.